All right. So this lesson, we're going to create a sphere painting. We're going to use value scale. And you can use any color as long as you have black and white. Before we go any further with the painting, we have to draw the sphere. We're going to use the image that I have posted on our lesson plan. Should be uploaded into your art portfolio, but we're going to use that image with the cross graph. Okay? So I'm going to draw a cross graph real quick here. Make sure we get the drawing as accurate as possible. That should be a straight horizontal line across. In there. So we have about a little less, a little over 14 inches. We have 7 2/8. 7 2/8. Cross graph complete. Cross graph on our image. Cross graph on our drawn surface. Right? So right now I'm just going to indicate the width, the height, where the sphere is going to intersect. Right? I'm going to just lightly draw what I believe is the sphere. Remember to keep your lines light. We're just trying to figure out where things are placed. Okay? So we have our round circle there. Alright. Now there is a cast shadow on here. The cast shadow is to the bottom right. Right? So it's going to be here somewhere. Avoid just taking a line off the bottom of the circle. You're better off trying to draw an oval. So we're going to take a line, we're going to start going to the left, and then we go to the right. Distance of the shadow, maybe around here. And again, a light line, right? I'm going to confirm some of these lines, the lines that I want. I'm going to erase any lines that I don't want. This is going to be this painting will be completed in acrylic. You see how I kind of draw the line from this bottom section and I move to the left first, and then I end up placing my cast shadow. There is a background line here that separates the foreground and the background. It intersects here. And for this assignment, you can play around with the tones of the backgrounds, the background and the foreground. And what I mean by playing around, you can choose where light and darks are happening. You can change that up. But for the ball, for the sphere itself, we're going to follow a certain process, all right? Right. So we have a division between where it's very, very light and very, very dark. Right. And then we all have, also have reflective light in this section. So what I like to do is I like to just kind of give myself a plan here of how I'm going to move in terms of darks to light. So I kind of create these ellipses in here that helps me figure out how the darks and lights are placed. Right. Now, the drawer is not really solid because I am going to paint. And while I paint, I'll make my corrections. All right, but I do want to eliminate the cross graph. So we don't need that anymore. Cross graph is just used to try to get as approximate or precise as possible. This assignment. Just clean that up a little bit. Establish some lines. I know some students like to plan their drawings. You plan, you can say, hey, I want to make this section dark. I would definitely want to make this side a dark tone or a gray tone, depending on the color you're using. Maybe you want to identify tones here. You can. Or you can just kind of decide that you're going to work towards a certain tone. For example, if I want to start, say I'm choosing blue, maybe I want to get the blue to go to a darker tone, so I say blue to dark, or blue to light. In the sphere itself, we're going to do a full value scale. Okay? Alright, so the color I'm going to use to create the value scale on the sphere is red. I have red right in the middle, I have black at the top, white at the bottom. I also have a cup of water outside the screen, and I have my brush. Now I'm using small brush. You don't have to use anything large. Right? Avoid large brushes. Large brushes make large mistakes. Okay, and I do have piece of paper towel to clean. Now you only need a small cup of water. We're only using one color. So I'm going to go right to the middle of my sphere. And you're going to notice that I'm going to paint in an elliptical shape, right? I'm going in this direction. And I like to move it up, down, and I'm going to go up again. So I really want this curved application. It'll create the roundest sphere possible. Now, when you're painting objects and real items from life, there's going to be all sorts of color changes happening. Okay? But right now, we just want a general sense of volume. Okay? General sense of volume. So, I'm going to start by going into my light area. So, I'll take my red. Here, add some white. All right, that is a good change, so I'll attach that here. And I'm also modeling and blending at the same time. I go back to the top. I really want to pinch this curve here with color. Continue. Get some more white here. Pinch that edge. A little bit of water, smooth things out, right at the seam, and get some other color, lighten it up, continue to create that curve. That color move a little bit more. More. Now I'm going to move some of this color here, let's get even lighter. We're heading towards the highlight. with it. Water. I'm gonna go back to my red. Trim that up here so that there's fresh paint there. And I'm gonna go. I'm gonna start getting darker here. Let's go with the red first. Let's go here. There's one more red in that there. I'm gonna go too dark too quick. And then I go here. And I'll start working these dark tones. I'm going to go back to the red. I want to just get some clean red in here. Got some more darkness in here. Start putting that darkness up. Let's make that darkness a little bit thicker, meaning a little bit wider. Now I actually want some reflective light coming from here, so I'm going to lighten that up just slightly, right at the edge here. Do it again. Maybe about here. Still dark, but it's just a little bit lighter. Bit darker right here. So I'm going to work my way up from here. Okay, so I'm going to have red here because it is a little bit lighter here. A little bit like this here. Okay, and I'm going to add a little bit of a reflective light bouncing in here. Okay, let's go back to the dark. Add a little bit more red in here, bring back some of that color. Here. Now, we're going to go super dark here. We're going to really have it dark. So, I'm going to add a lot more black, keep the red inside there. Alright. We're going to trim this at the bottom here. Really get that curve. Now this cast shadow, dark here, we can just lighten it up when we go in this direction. Okay? And what I mean by lighten it up is going to add some red to it. Because this is a value scale drawn or a monochromatic painting of a sphere. So many of them. So we want to continue to add the color to that dark tone as you fade away from the darkest spot. Shadow's going to get less intense. Bring the color down. Maybe some of that shadow reappears. That is the sphere with the cast shadow. So we're going to paint the background and then the foreground. When I paint the background, I'm actually definitely looking at the color that's established here. I don't want those two colors to mix. So I'm actually going to go from a dark tone here and then lighten it up as we go to the right side. Okay. So let's establish a dark section here. lighten that up a little bit. Right here, I'm going to make sure I trim it up so that that sphere looks really round. Change the tone slowly. Should we separate this tone here? place from right there. So the key back here is to change the tones. Add white, add black. Let's try to get some connection here by adding more red. Soften it up, put some white in here. Kind of a surreal background here. Alright, so we definitely have some changes in color, right? We're still working with value, alright? And I would like for you to explore that in the background. Don't just keep it flat. You're still training how to move color, right? So we're going to do the same kind of thing for the foreground, making sure that this image, which is the sphere, stands alone nicely in the surface, the space here. I may use some water, really thin some of this out, spread the color a little bit. Use the white of the paper. Missing anything over there? Thank you. sometimes you can see a little bit of a reflection of the sphere. So just try to add that in there. Maybe there's a double. Use some water. Put that idea in there. Soften this edge up a little bit.